Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Rev Up to Excel 2010, Chapter 8, Print Preview. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. As people switch over to Excel 2010, one of the first questions they have is, well, where the heck is Print Preview? And to get to Print Preview, you have to go to the Backstage View, File, and then choose Print. And Print Preview is over there on the right-hand side. Now, there's some good things about having Print Preview here in Backstage View, because you could change various settings. You can go from portrait orientation to landscape orientation, or change from normal margins to wide margins and see what that's going to look like right on the page. All right, so you know that's good. And the buttons that used to be in Print Preview, let's see if we can make the screen smaller here. The buttons that used to be in Print Preview are still there. You can turn on the margins or you can zoom in. So we have those same buttons that we had before, but if you really just want Print Preview, you're going to have to add it to the Quick Access Toolbar. So right-click, customize Quick Access Toolbar. On the left-hand side, choose All Commands. It's not in Popular Commands. And we go down to, there's two of them, you have to be careful. We're going to go down to Print Preview Full Screen. That's the old one that we know and love. Click Add, click OK, and now you have Print Preview Full Screen. Brings up the full screen Print Preview like we had before. All right, so a couple of, try it in the Backstage View, but if you just don't like it, particularly in landscape, it doesn't look that well, you'll want to use Print Screen Full, or Print Preview Full Screen Pickup. You'll want to use Print Preview Full Screen. Now, Chapter 8 is all about keyboard shortcuts, and so let me give you a keyboard shortcut tip here. If you're a big fan of doing Alt F1 in order to get the most recent file, Alt F1 to open the most recent file. Let me do that again slow. Alt F, see, it gives us 1, 2, 3, 4. That's not turned on by default. That's another setting at the bottom of the recent pane. Go down there and say, quickly access this number of recent workbooks. And you can scroll that up to 5 or 6 or 7. That way, Alt F1 through F5, or Alt F1 through Alt F5 will work. All right, there you have it. A couple of different tips as we're finishing up the new Excel 2010 interface. As we go further through the book, we'll get to some of the great new features in Excel 2010. And I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.